Jay Shrek about fell down, and that happens on occasion. Jay Shrek, I tell you what, another epic adventure. We're up here today to take another look and to see if we can get to the top of this peak right here and see if it discloses any of the mysteries that we think were available. Who knows? But we got here extremely early, trying to beat this crazy Arizona heat today. And this should be an epic adventure. I'm pretty excited about the journey we're getting ready to take. One thing I can tell is this volcanic rock that we're on is unbelievably slick. So it's going to be a treacherous hike up the top. I'm going to try to get up there before it gets hot. So we left at about 3 o'clock this morning. And we got down here to try to be able to make the ascent up here and also to be able to see the petroglyphs a lot better than we could before. So we're going to take this journey and see what's up here. You guys ready for this? Man, we got a lot of wind again today, so hopefully the audio is a little better than it has been here lately. I tell you what, the wind gods have not been good for us. So we're going to take a journey and see exactly what's up here, and who knows what we can find. I got a feeling that we might be in a location that Folsom Man existed, which means that we're not talking about 1,000 to 1,500. We're talking 8,800. Almost everything we saw was on this side, though, wasn't it? On the other side, right? Pretty epic day, and we started out extremely early. We got up at 3 o'clock. People actually do get up at 3 o'clock. It usually isn't me, though. But we're going to take a journey up this hill. It's going to be extremely treacherous. I can already tell you that. Slick. And we're going to journey up this hill while it's not 107 and see what's up here. There's our cave right there we're looking at. From this side, it doesn't really look like there's anything really there. But I'd hate to get all the way over here and not have at least explored it and at least taken a look to see what's over here, because, you know, we're already up here. And man, it's pretty treacherous, I'll tell you that right now. This is not an easy climb through here. Tell you what, it's steep as hell. This rock is just, it's brutal going through here. But we're going to go over and take a look, because I'd be just sick to my stomach if I didn't know we were already up here. And we didn't take the ride to get over here. So we definitely have had animals in here, that's for sure. Now, as far as if there's anything else, a lot of pack rats. We've got holes right here, some type of animals right there. There is something right there. Looks like a stick, so could be the end of a snake. You guys see that? Whatever it is, he's still there. I'm not sure what that is, but he's in there. Here's a piece of a rabbit. So we've got something big, but it's not anything. There's nothing in there. So we definitely have a predator's spot right here. Well, you know, we had to look. There's where we came from. There's the truck. There's what we're looking at. You know, if it wouldn't have been for these caves, I would not have actually climbed this side. But because of these caves, I feel I had to. But, you know, it's going to have to be careful, because this is ridiculously treacherous here. I mean, this rock, this volcanic rock, is extremely difficult to hike on. I've always had one sit down. I wouldn't call it a fall, but I definitely know that you get on this angle, like this right here, and man, it is tough going. So we're going to try to work our way back over to the area over here where I can get on these bigger rocks and get better traction. Once I get over here, I'll be in a lot better shape. Ooh. Tough hoking. It's tough hiking through here. Man, it's going to be even tougher getting down. But where we're at, we're looking at right there. You know, another thing it's going to do is it's going to give us a really good visual on this area up here on what we've got to deal with and what we're looking at. Two oddball humps right here. Very intriguing. I'm really interested in this area right over here. I really am interested in that. Big patch of green over there, which means water. Now the river would have come on this side. There's a river bank over there. So what we're looking for should be over here on this side. We just got to get up there and see what this journey takes us, man. Who knows? Maybe we'll find everything. Maybe we'll find nothing. But you know, I can already start to feel it warming up, and I do not want to be on these black rocks. There's a coyote right there, baby. See him? Hey, John.
Come in.
Got a coyote up here with me. That's what was in that den. He's right up here in front of me.
Well, that's cool. He was with a guide dog.
I think I heard him say, dude.
He's about
20, 30 yards in front of me. He's just looking at me like, what are you doing up here, dude? And there's a nice big hawk over here. Man, it gets steep from here on up. But he ain't gonna get up there talking. Let's just start getting up there and working our way up this ridge and really see what's on top of this, because you know, maybe nothing, you know, who knows? You know, but maybe everything. So let's get up this ridge and see. We had that coyote up there. That was pretty cool. But we'll zigzag our way up through here. And then, you know, like I said, I don't think this was the best way to go. But, you know, at least with these rocks, you've actually got pretty good footing up here. So we're going to try and not get on many oh shit rocks and just work our way. Look at that hawk up there. Isn't that fabulous? That is fabulous. There's that coyote. He's still working his way up that ridge. So hopefully he's going to stay friendly. You know, usually you don't get them like that. Usually they take off. They don't want anything to do with you. But he might have some babies down there, so that's hard to say. Look at that guy up there. That is unreal. Wow, incredible. Let's pick our way up through here. Like I said, I'm starting to feel these rocks. Now we're fighting the heat. So we need to be up and down and get the hell out of here within the next, say, hour and a half. We need to be up this hill and back down this hill before it gets hot. Because like I said, it's gonna be a son of a gun. We have to battle this. We already know what that's like from being in this mess the other day. And so we need to get moving. Well, there's our journey up to the top. I'm going to take you with me as we go up here and get to this peak. How cool is this? Wow. This is incredible. Truly incredible. There's a cross up here at the top. Wonder how many people have seen this. I'm gonna guess not a lot. Here we go. This definitely looks like it's been leveled out right here. So, man, that was a tough climb, but we're almost here. Let's take a look around, see what we can find up here. See if there's anything that's hoping that definitely is a petroglyph there. Right there on this point right here. So let's go up to the top and let's see what this journey has in store for us. Been an incredible climb. For sure. Some glyphs right there. Glyphs over here. Look at that there. Tell you what, you can just feel the energy up here. See that bird soaring across there? Tell you what, I don't know what it is, but it's something. Look at this cross. Now let's take a trip down over here and see if there's something that I'm not seeing that's on this edge. Now I have made the decision, there's a glyph right there. I've made the decision that I'm gonna go down on the south side. There actually looks like a trail, might be a lot easier, but also there might be something. Now I've already come up this side, so there might be something over there. Take a look at. tell you what, this place is absolutely incredible. You know, I'm not seeing a lot of stuff that, you know, you always hope to see. Cliffs and things like that, but you see a little worked out areas on these ledges, and you get a feeling that you're in a pretty holy place. I mean, this is a pretty incredible journey already, I can tell. Now, there's a glyph down there, which is kind of funny. But I want to kind of, there's that coyote down there. Wondering why I'm invading his area. I don't blame him. I wanted to make sure there wasn't anything over here before I head down to the south, and just to make sure I'm not missing some panel, because, you know, hell, I'm already up here. The work's done as far as the uphill work. Now, the downhill work is always, as I'll tell people, a little more difficult usually than the uphill. I keep thinking I'm going to pop over one of these hills, and I'm going to spot a big glyph, and I have not had that happen yet. We'll try one more ridge before we head back up and over the other side, because I know they're here. I know they're here. Definitely looks like there was a mound down there. Not sure exactly what or how. There's definitely a mound down here. Interesting scratched out area over here. As you look through here, very intriguing. Very intriguing. But I still don't see anything that really sets this hill apart than what we're seeing right now. So we're going to climb back over, try to go down the south side, see what's up there. See anything over here? You know, there's a cliff right there. There just isn't a lot of stuff over here that I'm seeing along this ridge line through here. So as I walk through here, there's a nice one right there. That's really all I'm seeing as I come through here. Not seeing a lot of stuff. I actually thought we'd see a lot more stuff than this, but if it is, it evidently is not on this side. So we're going to carefully make our way down. So somebody climbed up here to put that in there. All in a day's work. Another area looks like it was leveled out. Some nice gliss right there. Pretty hard to see. Right there. We're gonna try to get our bearings. Figure out the best way. There's a trail over there. I think that's the way we'll work over. I think we'll come down. Work our way through here nice and gingerly. And see what we've got up here. Is there anything? And I can tell you one thing, this is extremely slick rock. This is bust your ass rock right here. So we're gonna take and we're gonna work our way down extremely slow and cautious, definitely. I ain't gonna take any chances up here at all. Couple graffitis right there. Don't look super old. So one thing I'm going to tell you is we're going to really be careful walking down here. I can already tell you, boy, this is not a place to stub your toe. Tell you what, I'd probably go down the way I came if I wouldn't have already seen everything over there. And now it's just a matter of seeing what else is over here that we can see. You know, is there something up here that I'm missing? Because I definitely do not want to miss anything. What, it's an incredible place, but whatever secret it's holding, by golly, it looks like it might hold it for today. Wow, I just thought there'd be so much more. It's a nice petro right there. Get out of the sun right here. So they were working this. Like I said, there's a real prominent trail right there. So I'm not seeing anything else up here, though, other than a lot of treacherous landscape. But one thing I can say is it's another hill that I've accomplished. So if there's any positives, it's that as I gingerly work my way across here, that I made it up another hill, so, or a butte, as you might want to call it. We're still going to scan this as we go up to see if there's anything else down here that we might see as we go through here. You know, you're picking up a few more as you go down here. You're getting in some really slick rock, too. So, but not a lot up here. A little bit of graffiti. What I definitely thought was a predominant trail actually might not be. So I think that's a 1915 right there. Now just to figure out which way to go down the second half. Got the first half. Now it's going to be the second half. Does look like we're on a trail. Now this does look like an area that the ancients were in right here. So here we go. This is the point right here. I think this is what we've been looking for right in this section right here. I truly do. I'm seeing some rocks that are definitely stacked. And this is the area that we're supposed to be seeing right here. This is it. So this is what we came to see. I will guarantee you, this was the village. Here's an area right here. Here's another area right here. So on this point is where they were at. I definitely believe that this is the spot right here. And then they would have used that trail there going up and then through. Here's what we're looking for. I know it right here. I'm going to guess right now that we're sitting on a prehistoric spot right here. And this is what this is all really about right here. And I'm sure the other side over there where we saw the stuff grounded out, I'm sure that was the same. I'm sure that was it. I guarantee you most people would walk through here and probably not see anything. And you know, I don't know exactly if that's what I'm looking at, but it sure does. That's definitely a dugout area right there, for sure. There's not even a question in that right there. Right here. And then right, definitely right here. Look at that. I mean, you can see it. You can definitely see it. You can see the leveling. So I'm guessing this is where the village was, right in here. Some more of the circles right here. You know, so what we've run into, in my belief, is an ancient village. And that's what's holding all this secret, I believe, that's up here.